Welcome to the SDC22 Health Session. Hi, I'm Sungsa Lee from Samsung. I'm a developer on the Health SDK. I'm very happy to introduce Privileged Health SDK to you. Recently, we released Galaxy Watch 5. In this session, let's first look at the powerful sensors in Galaxy Watch 5 and see how we can get data from them. In addition, we will introduce the newly added new trackers and look at how they can be used through a brief code snippet. Our bodies continuously release various signals. Each signal provides an important indicator of one's health status. The Galaxy Watch 5's powerful sensor technology can measure various biosignals more accurately and for longer than previously. At the core of Samsung's breakthrough sensor technology is Samsung BioActive Sensor, PPG Sensor, which is an optical sensor that measures blood volume changes in tissue. Each sensor, which reads the heart electrical activity, and BIA Sensor, which measures body composition. Available sensors may vary by country or region. As a 3-in-1 sensor, the Samsung BioActive Sensor simultaneously measures and syncs multiple biosignals to provide accurate data. This data can help users better understand themselves and create lasting habits to meet short and long-term goals. We anticipate sensor data provided by Galaxy Watch 5 to be utilized by our partners in various fields, such as fitness, remote patient monitoring, senior care, digital therapy, corporate wellness, and drowsiness detection while driving. Next, let's talk how we can get a powerful sensor data from the Galaxy Watch. APIs for utilizing sensor data in Galaxy Watch include both health services and the Privileged Health SDK. Health services provide the users activities and exercise data like steps, running, and sleep. Measure health data by health services can be saved in the Health Connect and be shared to other applications on the open ecosystem. On the other hand, Privileged Health SDK enables an application to get raw and processed health sensor data, such as PPG, ECG, and body composition data. You can get common health data like exercise or sleep with the health services and track specialized health sensor data on the Galaxy Watch with the Privileged Health SDK. Now, let's look at how the Privileged Health SDK can provide data from each sensor. PPG sensor is an optical sensor that measures changes in blood fluid in blood vessels. PPG tracker collects raw data every 25 milliseconds and provides it once every 12 seconds. To ensure efficient battery use, this data is provided in a batch manner. HR tracker analyzes the waveform of PPG sensor and provides heart rate and interval value every second. When the screen is turned off, the sensor data collection is switching to a batching manner, and the sensor data is stored in the MCU without waking up the CPU. Sensor data collected in a batching manner is provided once every 10 minutes to minimize power consumption. Correlated analysis of heart rate and interval value can be used to observe cardiovascular health before and after exercise. The ECG sensor measures the microcurrent that occurs every time the heart beat. You can analyze raw data using your algorithm and observe abnormal symptoms of the heart, such as atrial fibrillation. ECG tracker provides raw data and measurement status every 10 milliseconds. The BIA sensor measures the user's body composition by sending a microcurrent to measure the muscle, fat, and the water in the body. BIA tracker provides 8 different measurement results, such as basal metabolic rate and body fat ratio. It provides a complete snapshot of users' overall health, helping them set goals with a tailored approach that guides them through personalized workout while tracking progress. The Privileged Health SDK provides a common interface so that Wear OS application can use all sensors most easily and quickly. The use of a common interface consists of 3 steps. First, call the Set Event Listener API to start the sensor. Second, get sensor data whenever OnData updated API is called. Third, if the measurement is completed, call the Unset Event Listener API to stop the sensor. The batching manner stores the sensor data in the MCU memory even when the CPU enters the sleep state. This minimizes power consumption because it only wakes up the CPU once the memory is filled. It can be useful if you need to continuously observe your sleep or health status in your daily life for a long time. Some on-demand type sensors provide raw data. Raw data is not processed, so a lot of sensor data is provided at a very high speed. This can be useful when conducting various analysis and more in-depth research while changing your own algorithm using the raw data. For example, by using the raw data of the ECG tracker, you can analyze atrial fibrillation. This is a typical symptom of irregular heartbeat. I would like to introduce our partner service using the Privileged Health SDK to you. Let's now hear more from the Clementine Francois of TOBI.
Hello, my name is Clementine Francois. I'm heading the Biomedical Engineering Department at TOBI. Today, I'll explain how we collaborate with Samsung to develop a system for drowsiness detection to promote health and build a safer world. TOBI is the global leader in eye tracking and the pioneer in attention computing. For more than 20 years, we've developed solutions at all levels of the technology stack of eye tracking. We also innovate attention computing with other technologies. For instance, we develop software that monitors drowsiness from the heart rate. This software aims to prevent fatigue-related accidents and improve health. Among the sensing modalities providing heart rate data, the smartwatch has become an obvious one. Moreover, this fast-growing market makes the solution affordable to a large population. Through the Samsung Mobile Advanced program, we've done and tested the first integration of our software into the Samsung Galaxy Watch. This solution is designed to provide the level of drowsiness as an input to other applications. In some use cases, experiencing drowsiness can cause accidents within a few seconds. Thus, it's essential that our software for drowsiness monitoring can access the relevant input data in real time to support as many applications as possible. And this is what the Samsung Privileged Health SDK enables us to do. The block diagram shows how our software is integrated into the Galaxy Watch and relies on the SDK. The SDK collects the raw data from the Galaxy Watch sensors and processes them. Then it makes raw and processed data available to the developer. The SDK enables us to access the relevant data points in real time for drowsiness detection, such as heart rate. Our software then processes these data points to determine the level of drowsiness of the user. Such level of drowsiness can be used as an input for any application or can be displayed on the screen of the Galaxy Watch. This video shows results from one test we performed with the Galaxy Watch for drowsiness detection. In the middle is the video of the participant. On the left side, there are the smartwatch, the heart rate provided by the SDK, and then the level of drowsiness determined by Tobi software. On the right side, there are two ground rules for drowsiness. One is self-assessment of the user, based on the Karolinska sleepiness scale. The other is an expert rating based on brain activity monitored through an electroencephalogram. You can note that the individual looks sleepy, and the drowsiness determined from the Galaxy Watch is very well correlated with both ground rules. Thanks to the Samsung Privileged Health SDK, Tobi's software for drowsiness monitoring runs in real time on Galaxy Watch. This new solution enables a broad range of applications such as alerting a driver, managing operator fatigue, and monitoring patient health. Now, let's make the world safer and people healthier.
Next, I will introduce the newly added features, Swellos and SpO2. Swellos information is very important when running outdoors for a long time. In these conditions, if you do not drink enough water, your exercise ability can be significantly reduced. But most people don't know how much water they need to drink to recover. The newly added Swellos tracker predicts and tells you how much sweat you sweated after running. Since the algorithm comprehensively analyzes the result measured by various sensor data such as heart rate, steps, accelerometer, and the thermistor through machine learning techniques, it is possible to accurately infer the estimated sweat loss. This gives an estimate for how much water the user needs to drink to recover after exercise. Now, let's look into the SpO2 tracker that can measure blood oxygen level. The SpO2 tracker measures oxygen saturation using different absorption rate for red light and infrared light of the PPG sensor. The algorithm analyzes the absorption rate difference between red light and infrared light by shooting the two sensors into the blood vessels at the same time and calculates the SpO2 value accurately. Observation of the oxygen saturation can help in observing exercise intensity control and post-exercise recovery in combination with the heart rate. Keep in mind that blood oxygen measurement is intended for the fitness and wellness uses only, not for the diagnosis and treatment of any medical conditions. Now, let's see how to use SpO2 tracker using the Privileged Health SDK API. The WearOS application needs to connect to the health tracking service for using the sensor. First, create a health tracking service object with a connection listener and call the Connect Service API. If you succeed in connecting to the health tracking service, get the SpO2 tracker object, then call the SetEvent Listener API to get the SpO2 data. If the call succeeds, the sensor is initialized, the blood oxygen level measurement starts. The measured sensor data is delivered through the OnDataReceived API. At this time, the status flag is included in the delivered data point. The status flag shows whether there is a movement or if the watch is not worn accurately on the wrist during the measuring of the blood oxygen level. If the status flag changes to a success after a few seconds, you can get a final calculated SpO2 value. The SpO2 tracker operates in an on-demand manner. So, when the measurement is completed, call the Onset Event Listener API to release the event listener. So far, we have looked at how to use SpO2 tracker through the basic APIs. Best practice for the SpO2 tracker is also introduced in the Samsung developed site CodeLab. In the Health CodeLab, you can practice SpO2 measurements simply with an easy guide and sample code. Visit the Code Lab page and try out the Privileged Health SDK. The Privileged Health SDK is available after registration. On the Samsung Developer Site Health page, you can apply for a partner program to use the SDK. Partner manager will review the application and reply in a few days. Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.